My name is Ilusi Ngeze. I am a primary school teacher at Ntakuje Primary School. I teach mathematics and social sciences. I'm here to present about a project that we have been doing together in a group for the past 2 weeks, and it is in a course called Online Course for Teachers, which is Becoming a 21st Century Teacher. So the main objective of the project was actually to be able to allow students to be able to do some arithmetics on in terms of fractions. And therefore, our learning objective was, at the end of the 60 minutes, we expected our students to be able to add two numbers, two fractions. For instance, 1 over 4 plus 2 over 4. And therefore, to be able to achieve this, therefore, we had to set up a strategy that we wanted to use. And therefore, we selected to be able to use Think, Pair, Share, which is a strategy called TPS in short. And so as a way of implementing this objective, we actually had to set activities. And therefore, we took two fractions, which were 1 over 4 and 2 over 3. We wanted our students to be able to add these two fractions. And therefore, before that, because we wanted to use TPS, and therefore the first phase of TPS, which was the think phase, we allowed our students to be able to do activities where they actually had to think of different objects that can be put into fractions. For instance, you take a piece of a cake, then you cut it into two or three pieces, and therefore you get a fraction of 1 over 2 or 1 over 3. So we wanted them to be able to list, discuss among themselves, and then be able to share what they know about fractions or parts in general. So that was the part where we discussed about the think phase. Let students be able to think individually, and then be able to share about what are the objectives, what are the objects that can be able to be used as parts or fractions as well. Now, in the pair phase, that was the time where we wanted our students to be able to execute or be able to work in groups and then be able to solve the problem. And therefore, we gave them the fraction 1 over 2 plus 3 over 4, then allowed them to be able to work together. So they were working in groups of two or three students together, and then to be able to share or be able to complete the activity in a pair phase. And therefore, that was what was actually being done. And then in the process, as they worked on that, we wanted them to be able to share now. In the share phase, therefore, we allowed our students to be able to share their own findings on their own solution on how they have been able to solve the problem, which was a fraction, 1 over 3 plus 2 over 3. And therefore, each group, one of the members from each group decided to go in front and then started to explain how he or she has been able to achieve the addition of the two fractions that have been provided to them. So in all, when we were doing this activity, therefore, we could be able to promote different 21st century learner skills, including there was collaboration skills because they were working together in groups and sharing ideas when they're solving the problem. So there is collaboration. But again, there is also what you call problem solving skills, because when they are discussing about how to solve the problem, they could be able to work together and they're able to think of different alternatives of which they can be able to use to solve the same problem. So that is collaboration skills. But again, there was also communication skills, because they could be able to speak up in front of other students and then be able to share what the method they have been able to use this particular, they have been able to solve this particular problem in the process as well. So such skills may actually be able to see that they have been developed in the process. And then, and therefore, as we did this activity, therefore, we were actually working in a team of 4 participants, of which there are some of the challenges that we have been able to encounter or how we have been able to meet as we worked over this group. So one of them was actually, some of the members were not very active in the process when we were discussing about the activities, and therefore we missed some of their contributions from their own side. And again, there was sometimes network problems where we needed to be online, but some teachers could not be able to come online, and therefore they could not be able to share that particular time. But in many cases also, when we are in different parts like in schools, the network was actually not very good enough to be able to go online and be able to participate in the process. So these are 2 main challenges that we have faced. But again, despite the fact that there are also these challenges, we wanted also to highlight some of the learnings that we have been able to get from this particular activity. So we have been able to learn use of different technology tools like Google Document, where we have been able to design our own document using Google Documents and then be able to share our lesson plan using Google Documents. We have also been able to learn about other technology tools like Mentimeter, where we could allow our students to be able to interact using the tools or the software package that as it has been used. We also have been able to learn collaboration over networks. So because we are teachers scattered in different parts, it was easy for us to be able to discuss together from different perspectives and then be able to bring all the ideas together to share in one platform. So that was one of the points where we were actually strong to be able to share in the process. So now as suggestions for the courses facilitators, in case they want to create other online course for this or online activity like this one, we would like to encourage them to be able to include maybe some graded activities or some marks, put a lot of marks to this activity so that other participants also, or other teachers can also be able to participate and share their own ideas. Because it seems like teachers have not been able to participate effectively because they were not motivated to be able to complete and see whether they can be able to get enough marks. And therefore, in the next offering, therefore, we are trying to advise or suggest to the course instructors to be able to include activities that could be able to create this activity altogether. And therefore, as I come to the towards the end of this activity, therefore, it's time now to give appreciation. So first of all, I would like to appreciate the participation from my members, Mr. who have been able to work with me for the past 4 weeks together, and of course in this activity as a group work that we have done. But we would also like to appreciate the work done by our mentor, Mr. John Peter, who has helped us in the process as worked throughout this particular activity that we had set for the past 2 weeks. And then of course, we would like also to appreciate the work done by our facilitators, from the co-facilitators and the different facilitators who have enabled us to be able to share and participate in this particular activity for the past 5-6 weeks we have been working together in this particular course. So thank you so much, and we hope you have been able to learn so much in this particular video. Thank you.